All right, good morning. You should have your homework out from yesterday. These are those three problems on substitution that you are working on for homework, and let's go ahead and correct those. Now, the first step here is to get one of the variables by themselves. So you could have picked any of these four variables, but I am hoping, I'm guessing, that most of you picked this y to get by itself because it's already by itself. And so what you're going to do is you're going to write the second equation, 2x plus 3y, but instead of writing a y, you're going to substitute what y equals into that equation. So you're taking this 5x and plugging it in for y. From there, you have to multiply. 2 times 5x is 15x. And then on the left side there, you should have added 2x and 15x is 17x. And then lastly, divide. Well, lastly, for this part of the problem, divide by 17, and you get x equals 2. Now, if you picked a different variable, I guess that's fine, but you should have still got x equals 2 as part of your answer. All right, now I'm going to take this y equals 5x and put a 2 in for x. And so we get y equals 10. So if you did it a slightly different way, but you showed your work and you got the right answer, that's okay. Just be prepared to explain how you went about it. So this is your answer. Make sure you actually write it out as an ordered pair. This means if you graph these two lines, they would intersect at 2, 10. So 2, 10 is the answer. All right, let's go to number 2. All right, in number 2, I think the easiest one to get by itself would be this bottom x. And so you take that second equation, you would add 3y. That way you get x by itself. And so x equals, you could either say 1 plus 3y or 3y plus 1. Either way of writing it on that right side is okay. And so now what we're going to do is we're going to take this 3y plus 1 and you're going to substitute it in for x in the other equation. So you're going to write the other equation out, except instead of writing x, you're going to write 3y plus 1. So I'm going to have 3, then 3y plus 1. And then you still have to finish that first equation. Minus 5y equals 11. Okay, now I'll go back and distribute. You get 9y plus 3 minus 5y equals 11. Those two on this left side, 9y and 5y, can be combined to make 4y. And now we're just solving this like normal, getting the letter by itself. So subtract 3, we get 4y equals 8. Divide by 4, and y equals 2. Of course, we're not done yet, but we got half of our answer. So we're going to take that y equals 2 and plug it back into one of the original equations, or this one right here. And I think it's easiest to pick this one right here. So x equals 3y plus 1. But instead of writing the letter y, I'm going to write 2, because y equals 2. 3 times 2 is 6, so x equals 7, and make sure your final answer is written as an ordered pair, 7, 2. You always put the x first and then the y. All right, and now for example 3. So again here, although you could pick any of the four letters to get by themselves, I think you should see that the first y on top would be the easiest because the y is already by itself. So you're going to put what y equals into the other equation for y. So in the other equation, when you write it out, you're going to have 3 times negative 5x minus 21 equals negative 15x. Over here, you multiply, you get negative 15x, and we still have minus 21. And when we have x's on both sides, you want to get them both on one side or the other. You don't want one on one side, one on the other. So I'll add 15x, get rid of this one on the right side, and then I got to add 15x to the left side also. Oh, but you might realize they're both going to go away. Usually we just get rid of one of them, but in this case they both go away, and so I'm left with negative 21 equals 0. Now that is not a true statement, that's a false statement, and so that's not the answer. Don't circle that. What you want to circle is no solutions. So you have to write out the phrase no solutions and circle that. If you graphed this, it would mean that the lines never intersect. They never share a common solution.